Wir machen weiter mit dem Letzten. Boxen in der Klasse bis 90 Kilo, angesetzt auf 3 Runden A, 2 Minuten.
Up next, ladies and gentlemen, a boxing rules matchup in the 90 kilogram weight division. Edward Zusupov of Germany in the mixed fight team set to take on Pierre Hachirobachi. Another youngster, another 17-year-old. Taking the long stroll down the ramp here. Well, there must be a mistake on the graphic because I don't know how you can have one fight if your record is 0-0. But at any rate, the 25-year-old Moroccan fighter, Pierre Hachirobachi, representing the Temple Fight School, 8 years older than his opponent. Boy, this guy looks to be in incredible shape. Like a brick house. Take a look at the chest and the shoulders on this guy. Built like a refrigerator. Another fighter out of the Temple Fight School. Take a look at the tail of the tape. Edward Zusupov of Germany. It doesn't sound like a German name to me. Got a record of 1-1. Pierre Hachirobachi of Morocco, as I mentioned, 8 years older, and somehow has neither won nor lost any fights, but does have one fight. Maybe it was a draw. Maybe that's what happened. Maybe it was a no contest. That's one possibility. It's really the only possibility I can see. Boy, that would be bizarre. I mean, in your first fight, you know, you're looking for some kind of validation. Is this for me or is it not? Did I do good or did I do bad? And if you get a draw or a no contest, it could be frustrating. Keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, this is boxing rules in this one. In the 90 kilogram weight division, 3 rounds of 2 minutes as Hachirobachi going to town here. That is him in the red gloves, the Moroccan fighter. And Edward Zusupov of Germany in the blue gloves, the long black shorts. Powerful shot, a right hook downstairs to the body. As Hachirobachi looks like he packs a pretty powerful punch. Zusupov has got that a big reach, height and reach advantage. He needs to start using it. Big combination shots fired off almost at will by Hachirobachi. Nice right hand that time. Caught him on the side of the face as he leads in with an uppercut that time. He's just standing there in the pocket and taking punishment is the 17-year-old Zusupov. He needs to get busy here. He can't just stand there like a punching bag because he's not going to last much longer. It's only a matter of time before one of those things slips through and does the damage. Now he's starting to get busy. If he's going to be defensive, he's got to start moving around in there. He's not moving his head. He's just standing there and taking the punishment. Nice uppercut. Now he goes for a shot. But Robchi saw it coming a mile away. Robchi, for a big guy, really moves good in there. He's really quick, very nimble on his feet. Oh, boy. That was an incredible round. I might even score that 10-8. That may have even been a 10-8 round for Hachi Robchi. And the only sign of any kind of a game plan at all from Zusupov would be that he simply wants to let this guy tire himself out and punch himself out because he's just standing there taking the punishment. Look at his body. Look at his arms. Look at his face. He's just... I can see his coach over there in the corner. He's trying to give him some advice. Do this, do that, do this. He's do anything. Round number two is underway here at Mixed Fight Gala 19. My name is Don Royd, and we are here in the Fraport Arena in Frankfurt, Germany for round number two. The scheduled three-rounder, 2 minutes on the clock here as Pierre Hachi Robchi of Morocco, the heavily tattooed gentleman in there, had his way with Edward Zasupov of Germany in that first round. You can see the damage on the arms. Wasn't just the arms, though. He was hitting them every six ways but Sunday. And we'll see if Zasupov has a different game plan here in round number two or not. Right hand found a way through by the Moroccan as he goes back to town with those combinations. And again, these are just two-minute rounds. We're halfway through the round, and there's just under a minute left on the clock. So, at least by my way of thinking, Edward Zasupov's game plan is not working here. But that's not me in the ring taking those heavy shots from the Moroccan. I wouldn't even be standing up right now at this point. But to me, it looks like his arms, looks like he's been sunbathing with only his arms exposed. Something has happened here. I didn't quite catch what it was. Was it a low blow, or did he get poked in the eye? I didn't know catch what it was, but anyway, we're back to action here. Not much time left on the clock. And so far, round number two has been similar to round number one, although the German getting his act together a little bit here towards the end of the round, and we've got some blood coming from the nose of the Moroccan. He's trapped in the corner here towards the end of the round. Now he's fighting his way out. All right. So a little bit of hope now, a little bit of light at the end of the tunnel for Zusupov as he's opened up the nose of Hachi Robchi, and he seemed to be getting a lot more defensive in there. It's the first time I really saw Robchi getting defensive in there rather than just go, go, go all the time. I didn't catch how he opened him up with that shot. Something happened at some point, about the 42nd point of round number two. Something happened to Robchi. I didn't quite catch what it was, but you can see he's really taking some deep breaths, trying to get as much oxygen as possible into those lungs before we start the third and final round here. So I could see how you could possibly score that for Zusupov in the second round. He really was only successful in the last 20 seconds or so, but it could have been enough to impress the judges. So if it was, then we could be looking at the deciding round right here. Nice left hook that time by the Moroccan. Caught him right on the ear, catches a few in the forehead. Downstairs to the body now. He is really working him over from top to bottom. That's just a punishment. That's a brutal beating. And now we've got another timeout here. Is he just mopping up the blood, I think? Referee wants to get the nose taken care of. Perhaps that's why he stopped it momentarily in round number two as well, as he just wanted to get the bleeding under control. Under a minute already in these two-minute rounds. Here in the third and final round, I think that the Moroccan, Hachi Ropchi, he's in trouble here. You can see it in his body language, and you can see it in the way he's fighting in there. He's a lot less willing to take a shot now than he was in the first round. His confidence is fading as well, as Zhukupov, again, taking heavy shots. It's going to be uncomfortable to sleep at night for Zhukupov, no matter what position he lays in. Everything's going to hurt. Oh, caught him with a nice uppercut right between the guard that time. Little peppering shots on the inside. Final 10 seconds now. Zhukupov comes alive. But Ropchi ties him up and brings that momentum to a screeching halt. And that'll do it. Well, the second and third rounds, I thought that Zhukupov did better. But was it enough to steal the fight? Or was the overwhelming beatdown that Pierre Hachi Ropchi handed out in that first round and half of the second enough to steal it for him? He may have done enough work early in the match to be able to put things off a little bit towards the end of the fight. Let's go up to the ring and find out.
Die Kampfrichter haben entschieden, einstimmiger Sieger nach Punkte. Der Boxer aus der roten Ecke, Pierre Hachi Ropchi.
So it was enough. Pierre Hachi Ropchi with a very impressive first and half of that second round. He kind of tired himself out, and after that nose got opened up, Zhukupov kind of took over from there. But I think that whatever kind of a punishment he dished out in that first round was more than enough to carry his momentum over and win this fight. Great job by him. Very, very powerful fighter, very aggressive. And whatever Zhukupov's game plan was, it didn't work this time.